Welcome back to the second part of the Pac-Man tutorial in Java. Let's get back to the playGame function. When Pac-Man dies, the death function is called. And we have move Pac-Man, draw Pac-Man, move ghosts, and check maze. We now have to program these game features one after the other. Let's start with move Pac-Man. In the first if query, the position of Pac-Man is determined. You remember from the beginning, in the level data array, how the game is structured. 16 is the point that Pac-Man can eat. If Pac-Man is on a field with 16, the score is increased by 1. With rec die x and rec die y, Pac-Man is controlled. The if query checks with ch if Pac-Man is on one of the borders, then Pac-Man can't move in the corresponding direction. The next part checks for standstill. Then Pac-Man D X and Y values are set to 0. Finally, the speed is adjusted accordingly. Draw Pac-Man is only a short function. It checks which cursor button was pressed. Then the corresponding Pac-Man image is loaded for the different directions. If dx is -1, then the left image is loaded. And the same for the others. Now we need a MoveGhost function that allows the ghosts to move automatically. First, we have to set the position of all 6 ghosts again using block size and the number of ghosts. The ghosts move on one square and then decided if they change direction. We continue only if we have to finish moving on a square. Then we use the border information 1, 2, 4 and 8 to determine how the ghosts can move. The line determines where the ghost is located, in which position or square. There are 225 positions. A ghost cannot move over walls. If there is no obstacle on the left and the ghost is not already moving to the right, then the ghost will move to the left. With the drawGhost function, we load the image of the ghost we want to draw. If Pac-Man touches a ghost, Pac-Man loses a life. With the code in check maze, we check if there are any points left for the Pac-Man to eat. Number 60 stands for a point. If all points are consumed, we move to the next level. Or in our case, we just restart the game. In addition, the score is increased by 50 and the ghost and speed are increased by 1. If Pac-Man dies, 1 life is deducted and the game continues until Pac-Man has no more lives. Ghost and Pac-Man are put back on the starting position. Now we still need draw maze, draw score and show intro screen. We continue with draw maze. In this function, the game is now drawn, just as we defined above with 225 numbers. It is iterated in 2 for loops with screen size and block size through the whole array. This will draw the x and y axis of the array. For the color, I choose blue. The thickness of the border should be 5. If one field of the array is 0, it is colored blue. If it is 1, a left border is drawn. Two is the top border. Four is the right border. And 8 is the bottom border. Sixteen is finally a white dot. Now I want to show the intro screen. All we have to do is define a text. I give the text the color yellow and define the position. I proceed similarly with the score. I choose a small font and a color. After that, I have to write the text and determine the position. In a loop, I check how many lives Pac-Man has left to display the numbers of hearts. So that's it for the model class. Always remember to import everything. The Pac-Man class now has to start the window with the model. Extend from JFrame. And add a new model. In the public main class, Pac-Man, Pac, new Pac-Man. Visible true. Title Pac-Man. Size of the window. Exit on close and the window position in the middle of your screen. That's it. Now we can start the game. Here we have the Pac-Man. You can find all the code of the game on my GitHub page. If you liked what you saw, I would be happy about a like, a comment or a subscription. See you in the next tutorial. Thank you for watching.